The substitution test is one way to determine topicity of groups of atoms in a molecule, but I want to show you another way here because sometimes the substitution test, it can be a little bit tricky to apply. So our starting point is going to be two groups of atoms. It might be two phenyl groups, it might be two methyl groups, maybe two chlorine atoms, some two groups of atoms in a molecule, and we want to know how they're related to one another. We're going to ask a series of questions, maybe up to three questions, but as soon as we get a yes, we're done. We have to ask the questions in the order they're presented here. The first question is, can we find a rotation axis which exchanges the groups in question? So we need to rotate the molecule, and we need to look for an axis of rotation that will exchange the groups that we're interested in, one chlorine atom to another, and we need to find a rotation axis that leaves the molecule indistinguishable from the way that it looked originally. That is, it looks exactly the same before and after rotation, but we exchange the groups in question. If I can do that, if I can find such a rotation, then I can say those groups are homotopic, and I'm done. If I can't find a rotation axis, I need to move on to the second question, which says, can I dissect that molecule into two and reflect one part into another part, exchanging the groups in question and leaving the molecule after that reflection identical to the way that it looked before the reflection? If the answer to that question is yes, those groups are related as being enantiotopic. If the answer to this question is no, I can't find a rotation, I can't find a reflection, well, I just need to ask, do the groups have the same connectivity? If the answer to that question is yes, then I have diastereotopic groups. If those groups have different connectivity, they are constitutionally heterotopic. Let's apply this. We will look for the relationship between these phenyl groups, starting with this molecule here, and its stereochemistry is indicated, one phenyl group up, one phenyl group down, so it's a trans isomer. And what we need to do first is look for a rotation axis that exchanges the phenyl groups and leaves the molecule exactly the way that it looks right now. Now, if you can't see these rotation or reflection elements, I would highly encourage you to build a model. It's really a matter of looking at the molecule in three dimensions and finding and seeing these symmetry elements. I think that with a little bit of practice, you'll eventually be able to do it in your own mind, but for sure, starting out, it's definitely a lot easier to use a molecular model. All right, so having just gone through the lecture, I would now tell you that I didn't build a model, and I'm just going to ask you to do it. Look for a rotation that is along the carbon-oxygen double bond direction. That's the axis of rotation. And when I rotate, basically the front half above the plane of the screen and the back half below the plane of the screen, around that axis, the carbonyl bond axis, the phenyl group on the left that's above the screen will move below the screen and onto the phenyl group on the right. I've exchanged the left phenyl group with the right phenyl group and vice versa. The right phenyl group will end up moving over to the position on the left, above the plane of the screen. The groups are exchanged, and upon rotation, that molecule looks exactly the way it did before. So this is homotopic. All right, those phenyl groups are homotopic. How about these? Well, I no longer have an axis of rotation because those two phenyl groups are both above the plane of the screen, and if I were to rotate, they would both be below the plane of the screen. So they don't exchange with one another upon rotation like I did in the first case. However, if I reflect the left half through the right half through this mirror plane, sigma, the mirror plane, those phenyl groups are exchanged. The left phenyl group goes to the right, and the right phenyl group goes to the left, and the molecule, after reflection, is exactly the same, it appears to be exactly the same as it does before the reflection. So there is no rotation, but there is a reflection. Those groups are enantiotopic. Moving on to the third case, I have two phenyl groups that are above the plane, but notice I've added methyl groups that are one up and one down. And so I can no longer use a rotation because the phenyl groups are both up, and I can no longer use a reflection because while the reflection exchanges the phenyl rings, the left becomes the right becomes the left, that's not the case for those methyl groups. The molecule would not look the same after the reflection because this methyl group, which is below the screen, below the plane of the screen, is going to reflect through and be down, and this one is going to end up being up. And so it's not going to look the same before and after the reflection. The phenyl groups would exchange, but the methyl groups will be inverted. Their stereochemistry will be inverted. The molecule won't look the same before and after, and so I'm left with, do they have the same connectivity? Are the phenyl rings connected the same as one phenyl ring is connected to the in the same way as the other? And the answer is yes. This phenyl ring, for example, is two bonds away from nitrogen, and so is the one on the right. The phenyl ring on the left is three bonds away from methyl, and so is the one on the right. And they're both equidistant to the carbonyl. They have the same connectivity. So those are diastereotopic phenyl groups. One way you can pick that up quickly is notice the relative stereochemistry to their proximal methyl group, the methyl group that is closest to them. This phenyl ring has a trans relationship to its proximal methyl group, whereas this phenyl ring is on the same cis to the methyl group that's adjacent to it. So we can kind of see right away that they have a different relationship stereochemically, and that's what you'll learn by experience to pick that up as being diastereotopic. The last case, we don't really need to go through the questions, although I said we need to go through them in order. As soon as you spot differences in connectivity between the groups in question, so this phenyl ring and the one that's buried below my marker, you can see that they have different connectivity right away. We don't need to go looking for axis of rotation or symmetry, because this phenyl ring is two bonds to nitrogen, and this phenyl ring is three bonds to nitrogen. They have different connectivities. They must be constitutionally heterotopic. So, hopefully you can see that with a little bit of skill and practice, you can get good at quickly picking up the topic relationships of groups of atoms in a molecule.